First of all, I think it's important to recognize that the roots of the pastry uprising, which is now global in scale, were grown right here in the Mission, and that this milieu will be writ large in the history of the Pyrect action, you know, leading up to the revolution. So that's cool. I mean, this is where our roots are: anarchism, anti-authoritarianism, and in fact, our media underground office is here in the Mission somewhere. Furthermore, I'm really excited to be here tonight as well because AK Press is going to be publishing a BBB how-to cookbook. So look for that in the near future. So it's been really remarkable to watch how things have kind of evolved. The first BBB incident was in 1997 when Charles Hurwitz, the CEO of Maxam, who's cutting down the Headwaters Forest, got pied. There was a long lull after that, and we look at it in the same way as, you know, it's said that the Zapatistas took a long time to prepare for their revolution. Likewise, it took well over a year to prepare for ours. But once it happened, it was just like, boom, boom, boom. Well, first of all, Milton Friedman got pied, the chief architect of neoliberalism here in San Francisco. Then Shapiro got pied. And then some anarchists involved with Reclaim the Streets in London were like, right, lads, who's up for a bit of fun? And, you know, a few days later, the head of the World Trade Organization, Renato Ruggiero, got it. So that kind of like just kicked things off. And because of largely anarchist publications, as well as AINFO's internet service, News for Anarchists, people around the world started reading about this stuff. We're like, yeah, fuck yeah. And I think it's a really interesting tactic for today, the pie in the face, for a few reasons. One is that clearly, if the people pie, the leaders will swallow. I mean, there's no question about that. Furthermore, reading the history of anarchism, you know, there was a tactic in the past, you know, the attentat of political assassinations by anarchists. And, you know, there's a lot to be said about it, but one thing to be said about it was it did bring down an enormous amount of state repression on all sorts of dissidents. And in today's political climate, it's an interesting question of what one should do. I mean, there are ethical and political considerations about physically assaulting a politician or a corporate executive, or, for instance, a sellout activist. The head of Black Rose Press in Montreal was pied for defrauding his fellow anarchist and being a power-hungry dweeb. Yeah. So, you know, and the head of the Sierra Club here in San Francisco, on and on. I mean, there's a lot of people who definitely need their just desserts. But anyway, when we were thinking about this sort of thing, I mean, it's a real question. It's like, clearly, there must be some form of retribution visited upon the people who are destroying us and destroying the planet. But, you know, there's a lot to be said for if they're physically hurt, what that does to us, to the movement. I mean, it's a strategic thing. There's a lot to say about da-da. But what we found is that throwing a pie, a nice fluffy vegan cream pie with a nice bit of force, is a really nice balance because it really sticks it to them. I mean, it really fucks them up. And it really, I mean, from comments published by a lot of people, like, for instance, Supervisor Yaki talks about when he goes to a grocery store now, he's looking over his shoulder like, fuck, what are they going to get me, you know? So, you know, that's largely kind of where we're coming from, that it's aggressive. It's not, we don't call it nonviolent in a proactive Gandhian sense, but we don't call it violent. I mean, in fact, I think it's quite generous to be given a vegan, lovely tofu cream pie in the face, you know? I mean, what the hell? I've had it 5 times, and the only times I've been bummed is when it's some swag-ass, you know, corporate pie. I mean, when it's a good pie, it's an honor. So, I guess, yeah, to wrap up, it's been a real treat. Since last October, over 40 corporate executives, politicians, and other characters have gotten a pie in the face over the world. The most recent real high-profile one was in Australia, the head of the Labour Party. So that would be the equivalent in a way of say, like, is Elizabeth Dole like the leading Republican candidate for president? Maybe. It's like the Conservatives are in office, but this is the Labour Party's top dude. And he had just given a talk about how to integrate Australia into the neoliberal global economy through APEC. and blah, 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 and was surrounded by television cameras and photographers. And all of a sudden, an anarcho-syndicalist from the Wobblies in Melbourne, boom, splooshed right in the face. Just it's media saturation, but importantly, not just spectacle, you know. I mean, I think what's important is trying to get around just the spectacle of an asshole getting a pie in the face and get a chink in the armor of the media. Like, we can hardly ever get our issues into the media, but this is one way that sometimes we can actually, well, it's like, well, why did you throw that pie? And then we can say, this is why. And it's been way more, like Chevron, you know, to actually get in San Francisco, Chevron's headquarters, to say that Chevron killed rebels in Nigeria, that's significant, you know, I think. So anyway, in Australia, just a month ago, a Wobbly was able to say, the Labour Party is selling out labor. And if we had just held signs, or if we had just written letters, as y'all know, you know, we wouldn't have gotten that. The great Max Stirner once wrote that, the great are great only because we are on our knees. Let us now pie. Thank you.